Hello. 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 Welcome to the Excited Education Channel, the YouTube channel which brings you about mathematics and biology. As usual, I'm Jamie Chris on YouTube channel called the Excited Education Channel. I wish you that each and everybody who's watching the video just subscribe, comment, share, and like, such that we can be together in all subjects and in all videos that I would like to upload on this channel. So let us go ahead on our topic of today, and it is about biology and earth science for senior one, and we are going to see on the structure of flowering plants in as our topic of today. What are the structure of flowering plants? So let us go ahead. As an introduction, the roots form the underground part of the plant. They fix the plant into the soil. So one of the different structure of the flowering plant also includes the roots. There are different parts of the roots. So there are cap roots, epidermal, cortex, vascular tissue, root hair, and there are different types of roots. So this is where we are stopped at rest station, and let us start on the different types of root. So different types of root includes taproot system. For the taproot system is the characterized by the main root, and that grows downwards into the soil, and it is lateral carried the rest developed secondary roots. In other words, this is said when there is the main root from which all other lateral roots are attached. In general, the taproot system are characteristics of dicot plants. Here we have an example like root of soybean, root of eucalyptus, roots of guava plant. This represents the taproots, and we find that taproot is the root system where it grows as the main root downwards the soil. And this have different examples like roots for soybean, roots for eucalyptus. Just check on those plots, you will see the taproot, the main roots, or the that long roots that likely to penetrate longer down the soil. What is fibrous root system? Another example or another type of root system is what you call fibrous root system. This is arrangement where there is no main roots. All the roots have the similar size. This is found in all monocot plants. So for these fibrous roots, they don't have many roots as that one of taproot. So there is likely to be found on all monocots. So for the adventitious roots, they develop from the other parts of the plants. They do not grow from a main root, but directly from the stem, as they do in bulbs or in or rhizomes. So underground stem simply means for the adventitious roots, they look like this one. So here, as you see, these are the fibrous roots. So this is what you call taproots. You know, they are longer and strong than fibrous roots. For fibrous roots, they start to grow from the base of the stem and then attach to one another as it goes. So these are also adventitious roots. For it, they attach on the stem and try to penetrate into the soil. This is what you call the adventitious root. So let us see special types of roots. Some plants have roots which differ from the normal, as we see from adventitious, from fibrous, from tap, and because they appear above the ground. Simply means they are called the aerial roots. So they are spongy and absorb water from the atmosphere and probably also mineral salts from dust which settles on them. So here these special roots, they likely to be like those ones that are in the atmosphere, and they are called aerial roots. They try to trump their mineral salts from the atmosphere and from the mineral dust or dust in the atmosphere. The following are special types of roots. So this is what we call clasping roots. These are developed by certain types of climbing figs and orchids. So for figs and orchids, they likely to have the clasping roots. They enable plants to climb by growing around and clasping its support. So these clasping roots, they likely to be found on those roots that are likely to those plants that are likely to climb the trees. They are what you call prop roots. These are found on trees like banyan and scrub pine. For scrub pine and banyana, these roots are also found on the stem of maize plants. Try to check on the maize plants, they have what you call prop roots. So prop roots of banyana trees develop from branches and they act as supporters of these roots. Try to check the example. These are roots of banyana trees and is called the prop roots. So those prop roots, they likely to have one part above the soil and another part is inside of the soil. So try to check on the maize, we'll see the difference. You see, this is the maize and these are the prop roots. So here let us see also what we call buttress roots. These are big roots like those of silk cotton plants. They act as supporters. These are what we call buttress roots. They like to be mud and they are big. So here there is also what we call street roots. These are roots developed from the trunk of red mangrove, what we call rhizophora. As these trees live in swamps, these roots act as supporters during the periodic change in the level of the mud. These are what we call street roots. Yeah, these are plants likely found in fresh waters. So yeah, fresh water, sorry, and are called red mangrove with the prop roots. Yo, these are the prop roots. It is a prop root, and these are what prop root, and it's also called to straight roots. So here we find that they are likely to be from trunk of red mangrove. This is what you call also breathing roots. Breathing roots, they are found on black mangrove Avicenna, and they are branch roots with which grows up from the main root through the mud to the air, and they are very spongy and take it in air for the respiration of the root system. So these roots, breathing roots, are likely to take a part of respiration system for the Avicenna, and the roots of the plant, like all other living parts, must respire. But in the mud of mangrove swamp, they may not be able to obtain enough air. For the breathing roots are one solution to those problems. So, what are the functions of roots? Let us see different functions of roots. Function have different operate different roles, and one of them, the roots fix the plants in the soil and prevent it from being blown over the wind. So here, if a plant have a root, it allows the plant to be fixed into the soil and remaining, or it continues to trump mineral salts, which prevent it from the leaves to be blown over the wind. So, and cannot be blown over the wind also, it means that it cannot be shaken with any inconsistent wind. So the roots absorb water and mineral salts from the soil and passes them into the stem. Simply means they played a big role, which is called absorption of water and mineral salts. They are responsible in that function from the soil up to the stem, and frequently they can act as food stores. So they store food for the plant's parts. So let us take an evaluation, name the different parts of a roots and give their function. You can do it and give an explain any three types of roots. So we have studied this and you can state it and explain it. Yeah, name two function of roots. You can also take the functions of roots. So let us see on the point called leaves. Leaf, they have general structure. Leaf is a flat green lamina or bland made from a soft tissue of the thin walled cell supported by a strong network of veins. So here, leaves are sometimes joined to the stem by a stalk and a petiole, and which continues into the midrib. So the main, what you call the main vein. So sometimes there is no leaf stalk, e.g. in monocotyledon plants like maize. This is a structure of leaf. So leaf comprises lamina. These are lamina. Yes, as you see, which is called also bread, and it have veins. These are veins. These are veins. Also, they have midrib. This is a midrib here. This is a midrib of leaf, and it have leaf stalk, petioles, stipules, and sheath. Even touched on the stem. Let us see different function of different parts of the leaf. Starting from bread or lamina, it's the main part of the leaf, as you know, in general. And vein, it is line dividing but not completely the leaf into sections. It divides the leaf into sections but not completely. This is what we call veins. For the midrib, line dividing the leaf into two parts. So midrib divided the leaf in two parts, the left part and the right part. For the leaf stalk or petiole, it is the part of the leaf that is attached to the stem. It is responsible for holding the leaf into the stem, and the stem part of the plant that carries the leaf. So the leaf is responsible to carry the stem, and the petiole, it allows the leaf to attach on the stem. Yeah, there is what we call sheath. Sheath, part of the leaf that attaches the petiole to the stem. Yeah, this is the structure of the leaf. Also leaf stalk, buds, and the stem. These are different types or different forms of the leaf, where we have entire single toothed, double toothed, there is robust and leaf carps. So here, these are leaflets. This what you call leaflets. This, it is the leaflet. So leaf, there are different leaves that comprises with leaflets, and this combination of leaflets are called the bread. So here we have the buds, where they like to develop between the stem and the leaf. Here it is a space where the stem and the leaf are ready to meet, and it is where buds are likely to develop. So also we have leaflets of compound leaf may be arranged in several ways. So leaves or leaflets of the compound leaf are likely to be arranged in different ways, where we have pinnate leaves, bipinnate leaves, we have digitate leaves, we have trifoliate leaves, and we have also another ways of arrangement. So by starting on the explained by one by one, let us see what are the pinnate leaves. These have the leaflets arranged in pairs. So if they arranged in pairs, one by one, hand in hand, with on the same arrangement, but in opposite to one another along the main stalk, sometimes with the terminal leaf at the tip, like in acacia. These are likely to be found on acacia, and it is one system of leaf arrangement which is called pinnate. Bipinnate are those in which each pinnate leaf is self-divided into pinnate leaves. So here it's like jacaranda. And for the dictate leaves are those in which the leaflets radiate out from the end of the stalk, like the finger of the hand. Just check your finger of the hand, how to see the leaf of the cassava. They are arranged in dictate leaves. So for the trifoliate leaf are those in which each of the consists of three leaf frets, each in soya beans. These are types of leaves. So here, this is what you call cassava leaf, and here it is a cassava leaf, and it is likely to be called what? The digitate leaf. And pinnate compound leaf and simple leaf, these are the different structure of leaf. Just visible it or try to zoom it and see this. So here, let us continue to what you call phyrotaxy. Phyrotaxis in botany, phyrotaxis or phyrotaxa is the arrangement of the leaves on the stem of plant. The arrangement of the leaves on the stem of plant is what you call phyrotaxa or phyrotaxis. So types of leaf arrangement. We have opposite leaf arrangement, alternate leaf arrangement, a whole leaf arrangement, and it's almost three. And the opposite arrangement leaf, in this case two leaf grow in opposite direction from the same nodes. If successful, leaves of pair are perpendicular. This is called what you call this decussate. Decussate is what you call also opposite leaf arrangement. They like to arrange in the opposite direction, you know, and you understand this. So, and also the what you call alternate leaves alternate leaf arrangement means that each leaf grow at a single node. For one node, one leaf. One node, one node, one leaf. So a whole leaf arrangement consists of three or more leaves at each node. For one node comprises three leaves. This is what you call a whole leaf arrangement, like in that of cassava. A whole leaf pattern arrangement can occur as a basal structure where all the leaves are attached at the base of the shoot and the internode are small or non-existent. This is what we call a hold. Opposite, alternate, and hold. These are the structures. So, let's continue to the venation. This is the arrangement of veins in the leaf. You know that the leaf comprises the veins. Those veins, the general term to explain the arrangement of veins in the leaf is what we call venation. These are two types of venation. We have reticulate venation and parallel venation. The veins are arranged in a network. This is what you call reticulate, and they like to be found on the dicot plants. So, for the parallel venation, these are several main veins running parallel to the one another and connected by short cross branches, e.g. on grasses, maize, or other monocotyl plants. This is the structure of parallel venation. This is the parallel venation, yes, and they arranged in parallel line. And for the reticulate venation is this one, like those ones on beans. They arranged in scattered way. And function of leaves. What are the function of leaves? The important function of leaves is to make food in the form of carbohydrates by photosynthesis, process by which green plants make their own food. Yeah, you know that leaves are responsible to trap sunlight due to the presence of stomata. If they have presence of stomata and the stomata are responsible to trap sunlight, and sunlight reaches in the leaves, they carry out all the facilitated process of photosynthesis, and photosynthesis is the process of making their own food. Those green plants likely to make their own food through process of photosynthesis. This needs a support of carbon dioxide from the air. And this diffuses in through the pores called the stomata, as I said, small opening found on the lower surface of the leaves, which allows the gaseous exchange. And this, they take anyway the entry of carbon dioxide and the release of water, oxygen. Let us check an evaluation to our today's topic. We have to ask ourselves, what is stomata and give their function, as I said. What is the phyrotaxy name and explain any two types of phyrotaxa. And
Name any two types of venation and give the difference between. So this is our topic of today. I wish so you understood and you have enjoyed my video. So thank you for watching me. I'm Jamie Chris on Excited Education channel. I wish that you have make subscribe, comment, share and like. If you did not do so, do it now. Thank you.